Why is everyone so hyped about cutting up the DNA? Like, we know where the DNA is, and we also know the whole sequence. Why not just cut it, and then join it? Well, as you can see, this is not 2 scale. Let's make it 2 scale. I guess you can see the problem here. Okay, so we need a tool that will do the DNA cutting for us. And this is where the 2012's revolutionary paper comes in. You don't need the CRISPR part now, but this. Cas9. Cas9 is an enzyme that we can program to cut the DNA anywhere we want to. We just have to give it a copy of the target sequence and it will do the job. Cas9 does this by going through all of the DNA in the cell and finding a match for the guide RNA. And then Cas9 cuts it. Before we go ahead, remember this, that a sequence of DNA that is responsible for something is called a gene. Now that the DNA is cut, 2 things can happen. We can join the broken ends back together, which would disable the gene, or we can insert a new gene. All of this is done with the help of DNA repair proteins. Let's say we want to disable a gene that is responsible for a genetic disorder. First, we cut the gene with Cas9, which triggers the DNA repair proteins. The repair proteins then trim off the broken ends and then fuse them back together. This creates a random sequence at the point of edit, which often disables the gene. Think of this as creating a barrier on a broken road. The road is now completely useless. Now we want to replace a defective insulin gene that causes diabetes with a functional one. We cut the defective gene with Cas9, which triggers the DNA repair proteins. But this time, we add a surplus amount of the functional gene into the cell. This increases the chances of the repair proteins picking up the functional gene and using it as a template to repair the broken DNA. Think of this as replacing the broken road with a new one. The road works normally and everyone is happy. This is what gene editing is. It's all about manipulating the DNA repair pathways of the cell. So it's so easy to repair the DNA. Why aren't we making our dogs glow? Or even better, cure all of these diseases. Well, leaving aside the ethical issues, CRISPR isn't perfect yet. Let's go back to our insulin gene example. Even if we add a surplus amount of template DNA, there's still a chance that the repair proteins may just join the broken ends back together. And even though Cas9 is very precise at cutting the DNA, it's not 100% accurate. So what happens now? Well, science goes on. There are hundreds of scientists working on improving the technology that could one day save millions of lives and even cure cancer. The thing is, we are at the beginning of a scientific revolution and it's happening right now. As we speak.